Good morning, dear children. The last class we have started chapter 5, that is the practical lab in computers. Did you remember that? Okay. So let us revise what all things we have studied in that. We have studied about the drifting continents. Okay. You have watched the animation, that is backward and forward, in the Gplates software. Okay. How can we open Gplates software? Application, education, then Gplates software. Okay. So you have studied to open Gplates software. Then you have opened the open feature collection in file menu. Then open the Gplates project folder. In that you can open shapefile folder. Then select all the files and click on the open button. Okay. Next you will display the layers palette. Okay. Next we can see the toggle visibility, that is indicated by the sign of an eye. Okay, that is in the layer window. Next we can make use of drag glob tool for moving the glob. Okay, while we are using other tools in the tool palette, we can use the control key in the keyboard and move the glob. Okay, and all the data files in Gplate software are called features. Such a data file set can be opened through the software are called featured collections. Okay, then projection in many ways are the 3D orthographic, rectangular, Mercator, Molvid and Robinson. Okay, so now we can move to our activity 5.2, that is let us find volcanoes. So know that boundaries of tectonic plates are activate with volcanoes. Okay, you have studied in your social science textbook about tectonic plates and a connection with the volcanoes. Okay, so boundaries of tectonic plates are active with volcanoes. So by using the Gplate software, we can view the volcanic areas. Okay, now I'm going to open the Gplate software, applications, education, then Gplates software. Okay, this is our Gplates window. Now we can make use of the layer palette, file, open file feature collection, then open Gplates project shapefile, then select all the files, click on the open button. These methods we have studied in the last class. Okay, this is the layer palette. We can keep it here. So now we are going to view the volcanic areas with the help of this Gplate software. Okay, so you have to click on open feature collection in the file menu. Click on file, open feature collection. In this you can see volcanoes.gpml from the creating features. Okay, not from the shapefile. Click on the Gplates project, then select creating features. From this you can open volcanoes.gpml. Click on the open button. Okay, so use feature collection to open volcanoes.gpml file from the creating features. Okay, that is saved in the Gplates project folder in home. Now you can see small yellow squares that are seen in the glob. Okay, so these small squares indicates the volcanoes. The small yellow squares indicates volcanoes. Okay, now to show the boundary of the tectonic plates in the glob, you have to include feature collection, that is C10 HTL ESR 2012 coastlines 2012.1 polygon.gpml set. Okay, that is in the shapefile folder in the Gplates project folder. So we can include file, open feature collection, then in the shapefile folder you can see C10 HTL coastlines. Okay, click on the open button. So we have successfully included the boundary of plates. Okay, you can use your mouse to move like this. Okay, now we can save this in your folder. Okay, how can we save it? File, save project, then have to click on your folder, that is students' work, 9th folder. You can give the name here. I'm giving the name volcanoes. Dot, what is the file format of gplace? Gproj. So gproj. Dot gproj. Okay. Next, click on the save button. Now the file has saved with the name volcano. Okay. Did you understand that volcanoes are found in the boundaries of tectonic plates? Okay. So we have to understand more about volcanoes and boundaries of plates. You can select the tool feature inspection. This is the feature inspection tool in the toolbox. Click on the feature inspection tool, then click on the choose feature. Okay, this is the choose feature. So this is feature inspection, this is choose feature tool. Click on that. Now you can see the details on the current feature. This is the current feature window. Okay, that is in the right side of your screen. So just click on the volcanoes. Now I am going to click on this yellow line. Okay, so the details will appear here. Okay, if now I am clicking here, the details has appeared here. Okay, so this is the method for showing the boundaries. Okay, these are all about volcanoes and coastlines, boundaries. Okay, next, dear children, we can move to activity 5.3, that is exporting gplates project. Okay, so we can export this gplates project. So did you heard about the ring of fire? Okay, now let us see how the ring of fire area in the Pacific plate can be exported in SVG format. Okay, SVG means scalable vector graphics format. So that is a file format for image. Now we can make use of this gplates project itself and we can export this. First of all, arrange the Pacific plate in the globe in such a way that it faces you. Okay, so we can arrange it. So we have to move this. So we have to select the drag globe. Okay, and arrange the globe that is facing the Pacific Ocean. Okay, so now our globe is ready. You can see the ring of fire. Okay, that is an area in Pacific Ocean which appears like a belt active with the volcanoes. Okay, you can see the ring of fire. Now click on export in reconstruction menu. Okay, this is the reconstruction menu. Here you can see the export option. This is the export window. Then select export a single snapshot instant from the window. Okay, this is the export a single snapshot instant. Okay, so dear children, this is little bit confusing. You have to remember the order of selecting. Okay, export from the reconstruction menu, click on export, then select export a single snapshot instant. Okay, then select add export button, click on add export option. Okay, this is the add export button. Click on that. From this we have to click projected geometries and rasters from choose data type. Okay, this is the choose data type. From this you have to select projected geometries and rasters. Okay, now click SVG from choose data type. Okay, choose data type, you have to click on SVG. This is the output file format. You have to choose SVG. Next, relevant resolution and give file name in specify output file names. Okay, here you can see specify output file names. You can give the name here, then click on the OK button. Select the folder in which you intend to save the image from target directory. Okay, from the target directory here you can select the location that you have to save. So students work 9th. I have selected students work 9th. Then press export snapshot. Okay, export snapshot. This is the export snapshot button. Now the image will be saved. Okay, export finished. We have got the status of exporting, that is the export has been finished. Okay, so these are all about volcanoes and exporting the G plates into SVG format. Okay, so it is little bit confusing. You have to make sure that each and every order of selecting, okay, opening the files from G plates folder, okay, which is either shapefile folder or creating features folder, etc. Okay, so it will be easy when you are using your computer and we can study this from the computer lab. Okay, it is easy, but by hearing like this it will be difficult for you. Okay, so let us evaluate what is the unique file format to save a project in GPlates software. Yes, first one is the correct answer, that is GProj. Okay, then the second one is practical work that we can do after the lockdown days. Okay, so this is a part, first part of the chapter 5. Next part is GeoGebra. So dear children, we can start this at the next class. So read your textbook well and write the short notes on the back side of your notebook. Okay, thank you.